What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's video we're going to be talking about vaulted ceilings in Revit. So that's basically a ceiling that follows kind of the sloped line or the sloped surface of the roof. You can have just a regular kind of vaulted ceiling, but I really like the vaulted ceilings where we kind of expose part of the roof construction, and then also to have some sort of a skylight, some sort of a window. So in today's video, I'm just going to be showing you how to create kind of the ultimate vaulted ceiling that has exposed structure plus it has some skylights. So that's what's going to be the topic of today's tutorial. Now, before I jump into Revit, I would just like to take a moment to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up just below this video in the description and then also up in the cards above. One of the courses that they have there covers exactly this, roofs in Revit, and I show you how to create all sorts of complicated roofs in Revit, how to set up their structure, and then also a lot of additional tips and tricks in terms of Revit roofs. So make sure to check that out. Also on my website, you can find some of my customized ready-to-go Revit templates. You can find some high quality, highly realistic Revit families. And also we have a plugin which might interest you as well. So make sure to check it out. Okay, so now without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And as you can see, here we are in Revit, and this is what we have. So we're just going to build out a simple house structure, I guess. And now let's create our roof construction and then also the skylight. So what I'll do first is I'm going to go here into the structure tab and then go to the beam tool. Now here for the beam tool, you want to see what you have in terms of beams. So here we have just these steel beams, and I don't want to use that, so I'm just going to skip that. But what I'll do is I'm going to go here to load family. And then if I go a few steps back here, what you'll notice is when you get to your family library, everybody should have this if they've installed Revit correctly. So if you go down and find structural framing and open up that folder, here you're going to have wood framing, and then here we have different options. So I'm just going to go with timber for this one, hit open, and then you can pick out a size. So what they'll do for this one, let's go with the 140 by 286, for example, and then let's click OK. Okay, so that's going to load in the beam itself. Now the beam is then going to be here in the beam tool, but we're not going to be using the beam tool. We're going to be using the beam system. It's just you can't load in a beam from a beam system because it doesn't have a button. So anyways, here, once you're at the beam system, make sure that the beam type is set to that timber beam. Then for the distance, I'm going to go with, let's go with 1200 millimeters, click apply. Okay, then you wanna go to set work plane, and you wanna pick a plane, click okay, and then you wanna pick this inside plane of the roof. Okay, so once we're there, then you can go with pick lines and just grab this line here, this line here, and then the top here as well. Okay, so once we have that in place, I'll just go here to trim and extend to corner and just fix this up just like so. So just kind of fix it up. There we go. We have that surface. And now when you hit finish, it's going to generate those roof beams. Now I'm going to offset them a little bit, but not too much. So what I'll do is I'm just going to kind of orient myself like this, make a selection of all of these beams, and then what I'll do is I'll come here to the geometric position of these beams, scroll down, find the Z justification, and set that to center. So it's going to kind of have those beams kind of halfway in kind of inside of the wall. Okay, so once we have all of this, then you can come here to the edge and see how the whole thing highlights with these dashed lines. You want to have that selected, then you want to go to your site plan, and then in the site plan you want to go to mirror, pick access, and then just pick the line in the middle. Go to the 3D view, and it's going to look like this. So here we have our beam structure. Now see how beams kind of stop right here at the edge. I don't like that, so let's just select the beam system itself, go to edit boundary, and then you can just extend this a little bit like so. So it's going to go into the wall and do the same thing on the other side. Added boundary and just extend it just a little bit. Okay, so once we have that in place, we have our cool exposed beams. What I'm going to do next is I'm just going to add some horizontal elements to hold these in place. So what you'll do is go here to architecture, go to component, model in place, and then I'm just going to go with generic models. Okay, set the work plane to pick a plane, click OK, and then let's pick this edge of the beam here. Then I'll go to the south elevation, I think, yes, and make sure this is set to fine level of detail. And now you can just come in here with an extrusion, pick a plane, OK, let's pick that out again. Use the tab key, OK, there we go. And then also let's turn on the wireframe so we can actually see the beams themselves. And then I'll come here to about, well, let's go midway. Okay, go down like so, and then go to the other side. Okay, so here I might extend this a little bit further, perhaps like so. Okay, and then I can just select this. Okay, this might be a way too wide. Yeah, so let's go down to 250. Let's see. Yeah, looks much, much better. Okay. There we go. And then let's just select these two. Go to mirror, draw axis in this case. Find the center line here or the center point. There we go. And then you just want to trim this here. And then for the extrusion end, let's go with 3 centimeters because I think that would work. Or even 2.5. Okay. Hit apply. Okay. Go to the 3D view, see what that looks like. And it looks... looks good. I think this is millimeters. So let's go with 25. Yeah, perfect. Okay, so once we have this in place, then what you want to do is go to the site plan. Here in the site plan, turn on fine level of detail, turn on wireframe. You come in here and you turn on thin lines as well, just to see things easier. Okay, so let's make this 30 millimeters just to make it a bit thicker. Okay, so once this is here, go to copy, uncheck constraint, and then move this here. Hit the escape key a few times, select both of them, go to copy, click here, and then unconstrain, and I'm just going to place this on every other one. So like this. And just go like that till the end of this roof. So just adding a bit more complexity to this structure, and now when we go to the 3D view, there we go, looks beautiful. Okay, so once we have this, now let's add the skylight. So for the skylight, I wanna do something a bit more interesting than just a regular like roof hosted window. So what I wanna do is go here to architecture and then use a roof, but I'm going to be using here the, okay, what's going on? Okay, let's set the work plane to whatever. Okay, so I wanna, for the roof, I want to use the sloped glazing. So what I'll do here then is I'm just going to go to my south elevation, go to component, and then use model in place to carve out a specific opening for this window or this curtain roof, I guess you can say, or sloped glazing. So what I'll do here is I'm just going to set this to, let's just go again with generic models. Okay. And then let's set the work plane to pick a plane, okay, and set here the front face of this roof. Go with void extrusion, and then what I'll do is I'm just going to kind of mark this out, use pick lines, and set the offset to 150 millimeters. Why did I do that? Well, because I know that my mullions, so curtain wall mullions, they're 150 millimeters. So I just want to make sure I have room for them, and then I can go perhaps from here like that, and then go up for that opening. And then I want the opening to stop here, so I'm just going to go up and off to the side. So we want an opening that looks like this. Let's see here. Oh no, so this goes all the way down like that. Okay, that I don't like the way this turned out, so let me just move this up here. Okay, perfect. So this is what that skylight opening is going to look like. So you just want to connect these two here, get rid of this one because we no longer need it. And then here, this one, I'm just going to fix up. So like that and like that. Go to the 3D view. So this is what we have. See how it's going to carve out so the light comes in at an angle. And then when I hit finish, it's going to go like this. And then you just want to extend it deeper into the roof. And it's really up to you how long you want this. Actually, it can go from one side of the house to the other just because of the weight. It's just because we already have the structure there and it's not going to bother the structure. So in this case, I'm just going to, let's actually stop right here at the edge. Okay, so this is now what we have. Now it's currently not cutting the opening, but if you go here to cut geometry, click on the roof, click on that, now it's going to create that opening. And now when we hit finish, we have that beautiful skylight, and it's just not like a simple window. It has kind of the length and it just looks a lot better. Okay, so finally, now if I select the roof, you're going to see that the slope is at 30 degrees. So what I want to do now is go to architecture, go to site plan. I can actually set this now to hidden line. Then I want to go here to roof, level 2, perfectly fine. Set that to sloped glazing. And then for this glazing, go to edit type. And here you want to give it some mullions. So as I said, I want to use this one, the 150 millimeter one. So once you place it on one of these, you select it, you copy the text. So Control C to copy, and then you click here, Control V, click, Control V, click. Click, Control V, click, click, Control V, click, and so on. And it just makes the whole thing a lot quicker. For the curtain panel, let's go with glazed. For the joint condition, fine. For the layout, grid 1, fixed distance, let's go with 1200. And then for grid 2, none. Okay, I think that this will work. And then hit apply. Okay, and now let's see what this looks like once we place it. So you want to use pick lines and have the defined slope checked only when you select the bottom line. Then you just uncheck that and then you select the rest of these. Oops, I did not want this one. Okay, so then you just fix it up like so. Fix this one up here. Go to the 3D view, hit finish, and it's going to look like this. So currently it's kind of a little bit below. So go to the south elevation, select this thing, go to move, and then you just want to move it up here at this edge. And that's it. See how it now fits in that opening that we made? And now if I go to the 3D view, this is what that looks like. And of course, if you want to take it further, you can use the tab key a few times, select these mullions, and then just have them aligned with the beams. So you just cover over it, find that grid line, use the tab key to find the grid line, and then you can align those. But again, you don't really have to. And in the end, we have something that looks amazing. So now if I go to my level 1 floor plan, and then let's create a camera view like so, and then I'm just going to use the little wheel to navigate. So let's look. Yeah, this really looks amazing. And especially if you go down and turn on the graphic display options and set, let's set smooth lines, set some shading. So these are just some basic settings that I like to use. And then when you hit apply, looks much better. And now if we just switch the sun direction, so if I go here to sun settings, set just from the top left, see how we now have some light coming in. It looks really good. I'm really happy with the way this turned out. As you can see, this is quite an interesting ceiling. This is something you want to have. Okay, so there you go. That's how you create this really cool lofted ceiling with skylight in Revit. Now, if you want to get this project file or any of my other Revit project files, you can find all of them on my Patreon page, which I'm going to link up just below this video in the description and then also up in the cards above. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.